Just days after the governor announced widespread budget cuts across the board, school districts throughout Maine are trying to figure out how they are going to get by. Here's the latest on how the numbers look. Education will be the hardest hit by the curtailment order. About $38 million will be trimmed. In all, the state hopes to save about $63 million to help balance the two-year budget, which is estimated to be short $400 million through the 2011 fiscal year. And that even has the superintendents who plan the best for this year's crisis scrambling to finish the cuts and figure out what to do next year. Project Economy continuing coverage tonight with News 8's Keith Baldi. Tough predicament, Keith.
It is, Tori. Every school district in the state needs to significantly trim its budget. Some have to cut millions. And it's not only this year they are worried about. Once federal stimulus money runs out, the cuts will go deeper and in many circumstances result in layoffs.
Actually, the first one gets it drawn. Let me see it, please.
It's a normal day of classes here at Oxford Hills High School, but what's going on behind the scenes is anything but.
You've been able to build the system, get a quality system going, and now you've got to take it apart piece by piece. It's no fun.
For months, Superintendent Mark Eastman has been proactively taking the system apart, anticipating a mid-year state budget cut. Before there were any solid numbers, Eastman cut $500,000. Then, when the estimates grew even more gloomy, another $200,000. Finally, the governor announced last Friday that state education was being slashed by $38 million, and that meant Oxford Hills would need to reduce its budget another $50,000.
All the shiny coins are gone. All the easy things are done. There's not anything left that's not going to affect everybody, and it's not going to be difficult, and that's a challenge.
To get to this point, Oxford cut back on supplies, repairs, and maintenance, and has left jobs open. They have yet to lay people off, and the superintendent says hopefully they won't have to this year. But Eastman says next year will be even worse here and everywhere. And when the bulk of federal stimulus money runs out when the school year ends in 2011, look out.
This is Evans Notch, okay. But next year it's going to be Tuckerman's Ravine. It's going to be more than a cliff. I mean, then the next year it's going to be Grand Canyon.
A reality parents in this school district and others are concerned about, with some worrying fewer resources will really hurt.
I know a lot of kids need extra help, and if the money's not there, what happens to the kids, you know?
Superintendents say they'll do whatever possible to spare core classroom learning, but they say the state may end up pulling back on efforts like early foreign languages or gifted and talented programs. Plus, co-curricular activities like band and drama may also be cut. And it's tough to avoid layoffs, they say, when more than three-quarters of a district's budget is for personnel. Live in the newsroom, Keith Baldi, News 8.